Hi, I'm Dr. Tracy Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Since the pandemic and the trend of working and doing school from home, have you had more trouble sleeping? There could be many reasons for that, but one reason that you might not be aware of is having a low vitamin D level from getting less sun exposure. In fact, even if your sleep is about the same, there's still a good chance you may have become vitamin D deficient in the past 2 years from spending more time inside. Vitamin D is a hormone probably most well known for growing or building strong bones, but your bones also need calcium. But vitamin D has to be present for the calcium that you ingest to be absorbed in your intestines. If you don't have enough vitamin D, you won't absorb enough calcium. In addition to bone growth, vitamin D also affects your circadian rhythm, also known as your body clock. How? Vitamin D is involved in the pathways that produced melatonin, which is the hormone that regulates your body clock. Also, some research suggests that there may be a bidirectional relationship between sleep and vitamin D, meaning low vitamin D can disrupt your sleep, and inadequate sleep can lower your vitamin D levels, so they affect one another. So vitamin D is high up on the food chain of importance for physical and mental health. It's believed that circadian rhythm dysfunction is one of the core features behind depression and bipolar disorder. So keeping your sleep schedule on track is important for a lot of reasons, and you may have a hard time doing that if you're deficient in vitamin D. How do you get enough vitamin D? You can get small amounts of it from food like vitamin D fortified milk and oily fish like salmon. The recommended daily amount of vitamin D intake should be between 400 and 800 international units. 3.5 ounces of farm-raised salmon contains about 500 international units. Wild-caught salmon contains a little bit more. A cup of milk is only about 100 international units. So in general, food is not the best source of vitamin D. Instead, the predominant source of vitamin D comes from your skin. When you go out into the sun, ultraviolet B rays penetrate your skin and react with cholesterol molecules in the epidermis layer of your skin. This chemical reaction converts the cholesterol to vitamin D3. Here are some things that reduce vitamin D production. Pollution, because pollution blocks the UVB rays. Aging. Sunscreen with an SPF of 30 or greater. Clothing that covers your entire body. Gastric bypass surgery, because this surgery bypasses the part of the intestines where the oral vitamin D is absorbed. Obesity with a BMI greater than 30. And then darker skin, because melanin, which is the pigment that darkens your skin, it also protects the skin from the damage from ultraviolet light exposure. But it also then reduces the production of vitamin D3. The chemical reaction still happens, but it means that the darker your skin is, the longer you need to spend in the sun to get the same amount of vitamin D as someone with lighter skin. This brings me to the question of how much vitamin D does your skin actually make? This varies depending on the time of day, the season, and the angle the sun hits your skin, which is influenced by the latitude where you are. The further away you are from the equator, the less UVB rays penetrate the atmosphere. So this means you have to spend even more time in the sun to absorb enough UVB. In some places during the winter months, you can produce very little vitamin D through your skin. For example, here in the United States, Boston is located in a northern latitude. If you live there, you will likely only produce vitamin D3 in your skin between the months of March and October. The intensity of the sun's UVB rays varies throughout the day. You want to aim for noonday sun, which is when the sun is directly overhead. But in general, the greatest intensity occurs roughly between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. So these are all factors that influence how much vitamin D your skin makes. How much sun exposure produces the recommended amount? Studies have shown that in summer and spring, with only about 20% of your skin uncovered, meaning you're wearing normal clothes with maybe your arms and your lower legs exposed, your body can make about the equivalent of 1,000 international units of vitamin D from 10 to 15 minutes of sun exposure. If you show evidence of pinkness in your skin from that sun exposure, that pinkness suggests that your skin made about 10,000 to 25,000 international units of vitamin D3. How long it takes for your skin to show pinkness depends on how much melanin you have in your skin and how intense the sun rays are. A dark-skinned person living far from the equator in the winter may not be able to stay outside long enough to get 1,000 or more international units of vitamin D. If you do get a lot of sun exposure, like you go on a Caribbean vacation or you participate in an outside sport, you can tank up on a lot of vitamin D. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin, which means that your body can store it in fat tissue for later use. So if you get a lot of exposure during the spring, summer, and fall, your vitamin D levels will drop during the winter, but you still may have enough to keep you from becoming deficient. If you can't get enough vitamin D from the sun, though, because you spend a lot of time indoors, or you have some other factors that limit your production of it, all is not lost. You can take vitamin D supplements to make up the difference. Some multivitamins will have vitamin D in them, but usually in low doses, so it's probably better to get a dedicated vitamin pill that is 1,000 to 2,000 international units that you would take daily. You can skip it if you do something that gives you a lot of sun exposure, but even in people who have normal vitamin D levels, 1,000 international units a day is still considered a safe amount to take. You have to be careful taking more than 2,000 international units every day, especially if you don't know your levels, because vitamin D gets stored in your fat, and you can become toxic if you accumulate too much of it. Interestingly enough, your skin has its own regulatory mechanism to keep you from getting vitamin D toxic from a lot of sun exposure. So the toxicity is only an issue if you're taking high-dose supplements. If you get tested and are found to be deficient, your doctor will likely prescribe a pill that is 50,000 international units that you take once a week for 6 to 8 weeks. So my own view is that it's always best to get vitamins and nutrients from food and not pills if you can. But in this case, I think vitamin D is one of those important supplements that is not as easy to get from food or even the sun, given our indoor lifestyles. And too much sun exposure can be damaging to your skin. And sunscreen blocks vitamin D's production. So if you are someone who likes to limit your supplements, vitamin D should be at the top of your list, and it's very cheap to buy. If you live near the equator and have an outside job, you probably don't need supplements. But when in doubt, get your level checked and get a specific recommendation from your doctor about how much you should take. Thanks for watching. See you next time.